Hey everyone, in this video we have to see how we can apply the optimal page replacement algorithm with the help of a example. So in the previous video we have already seen what is optimal page replacement algorithm and how we have applied this on a example. Okay, so if you have not watched that video, please find the link of that video in the operating system playlist in the video description below, or you can find the link here in the I button also. Okay, so let's apply the optimal page replacement algorithm on another example. So we are given some of the information. We are given a reference string, okay, the group of page numbers which are asked by the CPU at different point of time, and we are given number of free frames which are allocated to this process. We are allocated 3 frames, okay, to this process, and then we are asked that we have to find the total number of page faults which will be generated after CPU reference these different page numbers. So according to optimal page replacement algorithm, which page should I replace whenever there is a need? So this algorithm says, please look it into the future. Okay, future will tell you which page should you replace. Okay, so this algorithm says, look into the future and see the page that will be used after very long period of time. You should replace that page, or you can say the page that will not be used for longest period of time. Okay, that page should you replace. Okay, so let's see how we can apply. Okay, so here again we are given the reference string, okay, and these are the total number of frames, 3. Okay, and we have to find the number of page faults. Okay, so let's start. So this is my reference string, same reference string I have written here. Okay, and here we have the total number of free frames that are given are 3, right? So let's start. So first I am asked, or CPU is asking for the page number 7. Okay, so initially all the frames are free. Okay, or you can say they are empty. So 7 is not present in any of the frame, so it will generate page fault. Okay, I will write tick for the page fault. So 7 is here, right? Now next page is 0. So 0 will generate page fault because it is not here. Okay, so again 0 will be placed in the next free frame. Okay, now 1 will again generate page fault. Okay, 1 is not here, right? So 1 will generate page fault, 7 0 1. Okay, so till this point, okay, everything is same in every of the other algorithm also. Now 2 came, and 2 is actually not present in any of the frames. Okay, so 2 will generate page fault, right? So 2 will generate page fault. Now the question is, out of 7 0 1, which page should I replace? Whether should I replace 7 or 0 or 1? So I will say I am currently at 2. Okay, so just see in the future. Okay, future means in the forward direction, right? So out of 7 0 1, just see which page number will come at very far place. Okay, so here you can see 0. Okay, 0 is here, and 0 is getting asked by the CPU just after 2. Okay, so it is not a good candidate to be replaced because it will be used initially after 2. Okay, so next you can see here we have 3. Okay, but 3 is not here, right? Next 0 is again asked. Okay, okay, 4. Okay, 4 is not here, so I'm not looking into this. 2 is, I'm not looking into this. Okay, 3, no, not here. So you can say 7 and 1. Can you find 7 and 1? Okay, here it 1 and this is 7. Okay, this is 1, this is 7. So here you can see this is my 0, this is my 1, and this is my 7. So out of this 0, 1, 7, which is the page that will be used after very long period of time in the future? 7, right? 7 is used after very long period of time. So I should replace 7, okay? This will be demanded by the CPU after very long period of time. So I will say, okay, here I will write 2, 0, and then 1. Now let's come to 0. So 0 is already here, right? So 0 will not generate page fault, okay? It is like a page hit. Now 3 is not here, so 3 will generate page fault. So which page should I replace? So here you can see I am currently here. Okay, so I should see where is 2, where is 0, where is 1. So 0 is here, right? 0 is here. Now where is 2 and 1? So you can say 2 is here. Where is 1? Here you can see 1 is here. Okay, so out of 0, 2 and 1, which is the page that should be replaced? 1, because 1 will be used after very long period of time in the future. So 1 should be replaced. Okay, so this is my new content. Okay, now zero will generate page fault. No, it is already here, right? Four, yes, it will generate page fault. Okay, so I am currently at 4, right? And let's see, where is 2, 0, and 3? So 2 is here, right? And 3 is here, and 0 is here. So 2, 3, 0. So you can see 0 is very late after 2, 3. Okay, so 0 will be used after a long period of time. Okay, after 2 and 3. So 2 and 3, they can't be replaced. I will replace 0. It is coming very late in the future. Okay, so I will say here, I will say 4. Okay, this is like cross 2, 4, 3, right? Now let's say 2. So 2 will not generate page fault. Why? Because 2 is already here. Now next say 3. 3 again will not generate page fault. Why? Because it is already here. 0, yes, it will generate page fault because it is not here. Okay, so when 0 came, which page should be replaced out of 2, 4, 3? So you can say 3 is here. Okay, then you have to see 2 and 4. So 2 is here, and you can see 4 is not here. Okay, 4 is not in the future. Okay, it is not demanded. So you can see 3 is here and 2 is here. So 4 is not getting used in the future. Okay, so you can replace 4. Okay, you should replace 4. So 2, 0, 3. Okay, now 3 is asked. 3 is already here. 0, 0 is already here. Okay, so 3 will not generate page fault. 0 will not generate. 3 will not generate again. 3 is already here, right? 2, 2 is already here. No page fault. Okay, 1, yes, 1 will generate page fault. So I am currently at 1. Okay, and I have to replace either 2, 0, or 3. Okay, so 2 is here, 0 is here, and 3 is not in the reference string in the future. Okay, so 3 should be replaced, simple, right? So I say 2, then 0, then it is 1. Okay, so your 1 generated the page fault. Okay, so I am writing tick. Okay, now 2 came, it will not generate page fault because 2 is already here. 0, already here, no page fault. 1, it will generate page fault. No, is it already here? Okay, now 7, it will generate page fault because 7 is not in any of the frame. So I will say 7 is here. Okay, and which page should be replaced out of 201? So here you can see I am at 7. Okay, currently at 7. 0 is this, 1 is this, but 2 is not in this reference string. That means 2 can be replaced according to optimal page replacement algorithm, because it will not be asked, or it will be used after a very long period of time. Okay, it will not be used in the future, you can say, simple. Okay, so 2 can be replaced. Okay, so I will say here 7 will replace. So 701 is the new content. Okay, so 7 generated the, you can say, page fault. Now 0 already here, 1 already here. Okay, so no page fault are generated. So here you can see how many page faults are generated by optimal page replacement algorithm for this reference string. So if you count, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can count the total number of ticks. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, then 6, 7, then 8, and then this is 9. Okay, the total 9 page faults was generated by the optimal page replacement algorithm. And for the same reference string, we saw in the earlier video that 15 page faults were generated. Okay, the same 3 frames were given. Okay, and we got 15 page fault. So you can see optimal page replacement algorithm is far better than FIFO. Okay, only 9 page faults are generated. Okay, which are very, you can say, less, or you can say nearly half of the 15, right? Just for your understanding, this was the example that we discussed. Okay, the same example but with the FIFO algorithm. Okay, we got 15 page faults, right? So I think you have understood that how page replacement algorithm is actually applied, okay, and how it is working. So this is the best algorithm, as we have discussed in the previous video, out of the other algorithms. Okay, and this gives the minimum number of page faults, okay, in comparison to all the other algorithms. Okay? But this algorithm is not actually used practically. This act as a benchmark to measure the performance of the other algorithm. Okay. So in the coming video, we will see the next algorithm, that is the least recently used page replacement algorithm, which is actually used in the real systems, okay, in many of the operating system, and that algorithm is actually asked in the interviews also. Okay, if you like this video, please like and share this video, and please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. See you in the next video with next example or the next algorithm. Till then, goodbye.